tell you about a dream that I have every night. It ain't Kodachrome, man, it is in black or white. Take me for a fool if you feel that's right. Well, I'm never on my own, but there's nobody in sight. I don't know why I'm scared of the lightning trying to reach me. I can't turn to the left or the right. I'm too scared to run and I'm too weak to fight.
Meryl. Not that Meryl isn't good, it's just this late in the game, I would rather not have a water type. Another one. But we've got so many amazing Pokemon. A Meryl is just not gonna help me. Look at that freaking. Its defense is good too. How do you kill this freaking thing? Well, I'm gonna have to kill one in the Pokemon League, because Chantal has one. Luckily for me, I have a ground type, so. Though I don't know if I want to turn it into a Gliscor. At least right away. I probably will. Or, I also have a Walrein, so that could help too. Yeah! Good job, Walrein. Ah, freaking wild Pokemon. Okay, I'm just gonna run from this one. This level 39 too, that's so sad. Run. Clear out Route 22. There was one trainer that I did not fight who is a, what's it called? They're a breeder. Let's see, Surf. Go, Superior Walrus Pokemon, go! Ouch. Darmanitan, unless it has a very powerful rock or fighting move. Belly, ah! Ah! You cut your attack, fool. You could have used Hammer Arm or something. Probably wouldn't have killed Walrein though. Why would you laugh? I'm laughing because of the pain of the loss of my Darmanitan way back when. I miss my actually, is it Darumaka? Remember when I lost my Darumaka to Clay? I have not whited out at all in this game at all. And we're 7 badges in. In my old White 2 game, I did not do very well in it. Which is why I'm redoing this one. But also because the video quality wasn't good. It was like all wavy or whatever. This just looks better. Extreme speed. Oh no. Oh, how terrifying. Ouch. Boom. It's a good thing he did use extreme speed though, because my Walrein has thick fat, so your stab moves don't do anything. 49. Good job, Hellbug. I love leftovers. Excadrill. You know what? This was the trainer that freaking ended my game, I think, last time. And I want a little revenge. So, first, this Pokemon here is a flying type, so your ground moves don't do anything to me. Also, it's faster. That's cool. But in addition, it's got a good defense, so it's all it can use is to use steel type moves. Rock slide and rock moves, I guess. But I have the Eviolite too, so. I don't know why I use Sky Uppercut anyways. Speed fell, rock slide. Oh no. Good job, Dayfly. Good job. Okay. Dayfly, I guess, goes first. I'm going into a water gym without actually an advantage there. I have a fire type with a grass move, though. That's the best I've got. And, like, freaking Chandelure can hit, like, a truck. So, that's probably what I'm going to have to go into Marlin's gym with, which is another reason why I'm not immediately going there. What? Okay. What am I supposed to do in a water gym without a grass or an electric type? Shoot. Okay. I'm trying to be careful and not fall off. Oh. There's an Audino over there. Max potion. Oh, I know. Poison barb! Cool. Wait. I don't know why I grabbed that. Oh, it's Lunatone. Oh, it's Gligar. It's also half dead. Shoot. Bye. Gligar used to suck. It was one of the worst Pokemon, but when it was given an evolution and given a much wider move pool, Gligar went from pretty bad to pretty good. Look at its stats. Its attack isn't great, but its defense is pretty good. Plus, it has the Ebulite, so it takes physical attacks really well. Which is why it was able to take Excadrill's attacks. Should have been Battle Me! Well, that's rude. Never gonna make a friend with that attitude. Nose pass. Oh wait, Dayfly is two words, but I don't care. Bam! Sky uppercut. Damn. I don't know why he even did that. Good. Go, Gligar, go. Steelix. Yeah, I'm keeping with you. Yo, what up? My flying scorpion will fell your giant steel snake. And that was a crit. Iron Tail. Ow! That was a better crit. Good job, Dayfly. He did level, though. Unfortunately, I'm going to have to stay with a Gligar until, I get Waterfall. There actually is an alternative way of getting another getting a Razor Fang, and that involves going all the way back to Nimbasa City and doing some of the. Okay. Some of the Oh, I see. What are they called? The the name is escaping me. The train thing. The thing in Nimbasa City. Because they're there and they're very cheap. I think they're like 12 battle points. So you don't even have to do that. You can just go to Driftvale and do the other thing there. I like Stone Edge fine, but Stone Edge also only has 5 PP. So there. There. It just occurred to me that I actually couldn't have fought him right away. Or could I have? Whatever. What's up? So if you need to grind, this is a guy you can grind against. Hold this. Oh. Okay. Speed fell. He is -4 speed right now. And +2 defense and +2 attack. He's probably not attacking because his only physical attack is a ground attack. Sorry. 49. Grumpig! I was gonna use my bug type, and I remember I have a dark type. Ta-da! Pawniard is another one that's pretty good. Power Gem, cool. Actually, if I get a Gligar, then I can give the Eviolite to Pawniard instead. Pawniard will evolve very soon. 52, I think it evolves at, or 53. Ouch. You snore. Or something. Or not. Dead. Good job, Tarantula. So much experience. The fastest paced game is Generation 5, except for Wild Encounters. Wild Encounters are so freaking annoying. Because they always appear. Oh, Calcium. Nice. Okay. Am I done on this route? I think I am. I think because of the sheer power of my Pokemon, I can probably muscle my way through the water gym without having to have a water Pokemon. Because the strongest Pokemon on his team is actually weak to Ghost, so. And Chandelure is definitely a better Pokemon than Jellicent anyways, so. Gotta be careful though. Good. Alright, let's get ourselves a new Pokemon. Hold on. Let's get ourselves a Pokemon in Giant Chasm. Giant Chasm. I cannot go very far, but I can go far enough to get my encounter. Giant Chasm encounter is... Oh... That's actually nice. I think Razor Claw is like in the same area as, unless I have one. Hold on. I can't see my just regular items. Okay, so what won't kill you? Bug Buzz will. Power Gem will. I'm gonna switch. Okay. Slash. Could potentially be a nice alternative. In case I lose Bisharp and Walrein. Go Quick Claw, bam. Also, I can actually give it a good ice move in this game. I just need enough red shards. Because I want to give it Ice Punch. Okay. Punishment actually does more damage depending on how many buffs you have, not how many buffs you don't have. Duh! Come on. Perfect. Sneasel. I think we'll avoid Route 21. That's what we'll do. We went on to Route... We went on to Route 22. And now I think we're good to go. And we'll go fight the gym now. Cicada! Alright. Ah! Since Honeybee hasn't really been doing anything, Power Jam! Just showing off the sheer force that is Vespiquen. Goodbye! I haven't run into a Wingull at all. Unfortunately, Wingull is not available in any of the routes that we've gone to yet. So, that's annoying. Like, I wouldn't mind if Wingull was available in the water here. And I'd have a chance of getting at least something I didn't have before, but unfortunately it's not here. It's just Basculin and Corsola, both in the other thing. Oh. How do I get back there? Okay. I have to go around and then up the beach way. The mighty walrus. Shellbell! Cool. Because the leftovers is actually better, but whatever. So, it looks like a biodome dome greenhouse or something. Would have been cooler if Marlin and Charon had different types. Humil Owl City Pokemon Gym Leader Marlin. More splash than the sea. It's like a resort. This gym may feel like a resort, but the gym leader is no picnic. This is a present for me. Please focus and prepare. Oh, maybe I should heal first. In Humilow's Pokemon Gym, you may proceed by hopping on the lily pads, sliding across the water surface. Here's another piece of advice. Water-type Pokemon really don't like electric-type or grass-type moves. But I'm sure the gym leader has planned for that. Oh, probably. Let's go heal first. We got a Sneasel, we got a Mindfoo in reserve, and that's all we got. Since I can't fly, my only way back is by, my only way back is just, like, walking and biking. So, that's why I really don't want to go all the way back there. Alright, I wanted to look and see if I had a razor claw. And I'm pretty sure I do. Oops. Oh, I hate the bag sort system. Tight. There. Do I have a razor claw? I don't. That's too bad. Okay. Fight you first. How do you like riding on leaves? If you manage to beat me, I'll teach you something good. You'll see. Okay. Bloatzel. We're both from Sinnoh! Sinnoh remix, hopefully confirmed. Okay. Ouch. Wow. Ooh. Ouch. Mantine. This is dangerous because it could potentially kill it. Oh, actually, no. It won't kill it, at least on the first turn. Rock slide. What? Alright. Wow! Ah, slugged you! Alright. Where's my potions? Okay. Good job, honeybee. Okay. Dang. Hello. It's said that the water will not grow stagnant as long as it keeps flowing. So long as I keep moving onward. Okay. Actually, I don't understand what she said to me. Hi. I love it. I love her cry. Also, I love that Vespiquen is going to be in Sword and Shield. No, it's in Sword and Shield. Safeguard. Best thing about this thing is, as soon as you get wild area and you have, like, either a sunny or a regular area in the wild area, you will get a Combee. That's what I got before, and yeah, Combee also evolves very quickly. It evolves at 21. All right, good job, Vespiquen. Switch for. Oh, that's a bad plan. Oh, I'm gonna go with Tarantula first. Let me see your stats again. Great defenses. This is definitely the best of the bug flying types. But there isn't much competition. Who is there? There's Ninjask. It's got speed, but it can't take any hits. There's Butterfree, the basic bug Pokemon, which is really not good. I mean, honestly, Butterfree should not have been a flying type. I mean, yeah, it can fly, but who cares? So can Venomoth. It should have been a bug psychic type. That would have made it so much better. And then there's Masquerade, which is the weirdest bug flying type because it evolved from a bug water type. Oh, to think you would deliberately seek me out for a battle. I am so tickled that I won't hold anything back as a reward. Okay. And then there's Mothim, which is part of an already horrible line. This thing's gonna be mean. Alright, so let's see. Do you have a water move?